All right. I just want to say thank you for coming to my workshop today. So welcome. My name is Delphine Ravix. I am an undergraduate student here. I'm double majoring in computer science and IT. I got involved with computer science when I was 16. I did a program called Grocery Code, and it was at Twitter in Cambridge. And prior to that, I didn't know anything about computer science, but I did like computers a lot growing up. I did a technology club in ninth grade, so that's where I like broke apart computers. I was always more interested in the IT side, but I got into programming when I went to Girls Who Code, and I hated it. It took over my whole summer. But by the end of the program, I realized I really like programming, and it really gets your brain to work. So that's how I got involved into programming. And when I'm not here, I'm also Beyonce. But what is computer programming? The Wikipedia definition is, it's a process that leads from an original formulation of a computing problem to executable computer programs. But in regular people language, it's programming is the process of creating a set of instructions that tell a computer how to do a task. So therefore, programming is basically everywhere. So in your phones, in cars, in hospitals, in games, everything that you do, basically somebody had computer programmed it to do what it does. And is anybody familiar with any programming languages? What kind?
I took a Python class in undergrad, and I didn't do great, but.
Joanna? They're markup languages. I know markup languages pretty well, but programming, I'm familiar with C++ because all of my friends were taking classes in it.
Do you know?
A little C++, a little Java, kind of like a little everything.
I know Java. I think I'm most fluent in Java. I did take Python my freshman year, and when I was in the Girls Who Code program, we did like a whole bunch of, each week was a different programming language, but I don't remember those. But I know HTML was one of them, but my first language that I learned was Scratch. And so a programming language is a special language or syntax programmers use to develop a software, program scripts or other sets of instructions. And like we were saying before, some of us do know Python, some of us know Java. There's Ruby on Rails also and SQL. And a lot of them you could come to the same conclusion with them. It's just like people's like regular language. I could say something in Spanish, or somebody could say something in English, and then they get to the same result. Like both there, you could say it in different languages, and get the same result. So, this workshop's objective, I wanted to introduce you guys to processing JS. I was introduced kind of processing JS through my little brother. I wanted to get him into computer programming, so I went on Khan Academy, and that's the one that Khan Academy uses to get little kids to really understand programming. So, and I thought it was easy, so I thought that would be good for us today too. And also to learn how to draw basic shapes using the Processing JS library. And also, I loved Pac-Man growing up, so I wanted to create the visuals for Pac-Man. So, you guys create the open processing account already?
I'm having trouble just logging in from the network at all.
Are you a student?
Yeah. It should just be like my username.
If it does that shaky thing, you might need to just do it another computer.
Okay. So, right here where it says mode, right now it's in PF.js, so we're just going to click Processing JS. Oh, but before we do that, we could actually see what does this code do right now. So you could just click on it, and then you see that whenever you move the mouse, these little dots follow. So that's what this current code does, and it just came up when you opened this new sketch. So now we're going to go switch over to processing JS, and then we're going to, we could just erase this, because this was the syntax for the PF5JS. What we're going to do first, we're going to set up, we're going to type in void set up. And we're going to put opening and closing brackets. And this is us setting up the window for a new visual. So we're going to do size. The size of the window is going to be 500 by 500. And don't forget your semicolon.
Never forget the semicolons.
Are you doing, like, is that one space that you did for the
unit?
Okay, one space, okay.
I don't think spaces are very important in this one.
Okay.
So.
I remember them being very important in Python.
Okay. Some languages are like iffy about that, some aren't. This one I don't believe so. Also, we're gonna do another one called void draw. And we could see, we could press the play button to see what it looks like right now. So we see now we have a 500 by 500 window on the screen. And, so now we have nothing on it. So now we're going to type in background. Put a value into it, so I'm going to put 0, and we're going to see what we get. So now we see the background has changed to black. So this is a color value. So if I put 50, so by 5, I change the color to white. But Pac-Man background is usually black, so we're going to leave that at 0. So for processing JS, there's a lot of different functions or method names that they use. So background, it sets the background used for the processing window. The rectangle function, it draws a rectangle on the screen. Arc draws an arc in the display window. The ellipse draws an oval or circle. Also, the stroke function, it sets the color used to draw lines and borders around shapes. The fill sets the color it fills in the shape that you draw. And no stroke, it doesn't put a stroke around whatever shape you draw. So we'll see this throughout the workshop as well. So this is the background, so now we set the background to zero, so now it's black. So the first thing we're going to do, I want you guys to play around with this. So we're going to draw some shapes. So for the rectangle, like we saw here, to draw a rectangle, you put it, the XY stands for like where in the window you want it. So since we put 500 by 500, so the max window is from 0 to 500. And then the Y is from 0 to 500. It's like a coordinate grid, basically. So it's a 500 by 500 coordinate grid. The width and the height is the basically the width of the shape, the width of the rectangle you would want, and how tall you would want it to be. So now, if we put rectangle, a white square right now. And then there's also other shapes you could put as well. There's an ellipse, which is an oval. So here's the same thing. Let's not use 50 because it'll just go in the same area. Let's try to move it. So now I get this shape. So you guys are playing around with this a little if you want, and let's try the arc function. I want to see. Okay, sorry, never. So now we could fill in the shapes. By using the fill function. And then within the fill function, we could give it different values. We could give it one value or we could give it a RGB value. So we could give it, we're going to do fill 255. We're not going to give it a stroke. RGB value will give it a better color because this one is just going from like white to gray. Sorry. Here. RGB stands for red, green, or blue, so therefore it's like a mix of three colors. So as long as you change it, you can do 100. That's the red value. So we change it, we get this color blue. The B, we could change that to 185, and then we get still, it's a little different shade of blue because you add more blue value to it. And let's see, we put a value of red 5, and then we get this green. This green color. So therefore, it just varies depending on the RGB value you give it. And then here, if you do put a stroke, we could put a stroke and then we put 5. Hold on. Because I believe the stroke is black right now, so you won't be able to see it against the border. But we can erase everything we have here now. So what we're going to start off doing, so in Pac-Man, we have, what does Pac-Man look like to you guys? How would you guys describe it?
It's a big yellow ellipse with like a triangle pizza slice, like cut out for the mouth.
Mm-hmm. And what else is in the game as well?
The ghosts and the walls.
The white pellets, little tiny ellipses.
So, if you guys could copy this down into your sketch.
Just what you have.
The highlighted part. There we go. So you guys see this. So try changing the stroke weight to 8. What happens? It gets thicker. So the stroke weight is basically how thick you want the outer layer to be.
Is that in pixels?
Yes, this is pixels. So remember this 0 by 500 grid. So therefore, right now, if the thickness is 8, so therefore the outside layer, it goes from 0 to 8, and then it goes from 492 to 500. You understand?
Yeah.
So those corners.
Okay.
So we could change it back to 4 as it was originally.
Is there any way to make the code on your screen just a little bit bigger? That's a much better thing.
So? That's what it's going on. So next. So that's the first outer square.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the outer square of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So now, do you guys think you can make another square? Make a smaller square. And we're trying to basically see if you could get it to look like this. There's one big square. There's one other square here. There's one other square here. 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 And here. So if you could do 6 inner squares, and you guys can let me know if you got it.
Squares or rectangles?
Rectangles, sorry. We're going to be using the ellipse function, and also we're going to be using a loop. And is everybody familiar with what a loop is?
Sort of.
Okay, so let's say, okay. This is what we want it to look like. So a loop is a repetitive, something you do repeatedly and then adds on to it. That's not a good explanation, but I'll try to write it. So we're going to be using this loop for int I equals 0, I plus plus I is less than 5. Am I writing it right for you?
Yeah.
Somebody?
Yeah.
Am I doing it good? Okay. Alright, so this is basically saying we're going to have an integer, so a number, that's equal to 0. And at the start of this loop, right here, is equal to 0. So right now, I equals 0. So you're going to tell it to do something within this loop. So therefore, I'm going to say, print hello. Right? So, and then it's going to close. So this, I'm going to keep on doing this until this is not true anymore.
Okay.
Until I is greater than 3 or if it's equal to 3.
Okay.
So how many times do you think it's going to print hello?
2 or 3?
3 times, yeah. So the first time, because right now it's at 0, so it prints hello.
Yeah.
So right now, it prints hello once. So now I equals, because I plus plus adds on to it. So now I equals 1. So it's still 1. 1 is still less than 3, so it prints hello again.
Yeah.
And then it becomes 2, I equals 2. So it prints hello again. I equals 3. 3 is not less than 3, but it's equal to 3. So it stops, but in total we have 1, 2, 3 hellos. So basically that's what a loop does.
Nice, thank you.
So, So now we're going to get to drawing the pellets. So first, we're going to do a float. We're going to make a variable called float. Not float. We're going to make a variable that's called x, but this variable is going to be a float, which is its it's what type it is. So it could be an integer, it could be a float, it could be a decimal, but this one, a float is basically an integer, but this one would be more specific. It could have like extra zeros or decimals in the end. So that's what a float is. So we're going to name it x and y. And I put x and y because like that's the it's easier to remember as the coordinates of where you want each pellet to be. And you could put it, at the top of the in line ones and two.
Okay.
Don't put it in the draw. You got a stuff? So you put this right here.
And that defines those two variables?
I think it initializes them. It initializes them. It's not defined yet because it's not given a value. So therefore, and then we're going to make a function called drawPackDocs, which are the white palettes. So put it after void setup. You don't have to write this part right here. You guys have it?
Is there supposed to be another? I see two left curly brackets, but only one right that's closing it.
Which one? This one?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Because it's at the bottom, I don't want to scroll down.
Okay.
But yeah, just put another bracket right here. All right.
Like the bottom.
The closing bracket after the function.
Okay.
So before, I'm going to explain this to you guys. So here, we're filling it with a value of 255, which means that the pellets are going to be white, and it's not going to have a stroke. So x equals 5 is basically, this is saying, now this is the float variable that we, well, this is called, the variable is called x, but the data type is a float. So it's basically saying, is what I'm saying. So x is going to be equal to 5 at the beginning of this. So we're first creating, this is creating the first row of pellets. So since there's boxes right here, there's 6 boxes, this right here is creating the first row of pellets. And where we're going to start at, we're going to start making it at x equals 5. So x equals 5 could be like right here. So this is where it's going to start. And it says, it's saying for x equals 5 and for int I equals 1, and if I is less than 24, so there should be about 24 pellets. We're gonna skip 20 spaces, 20 pixels, and then we're gonna draw another one. So, and we're gonna do this 24 times. So therefore, we're gonna skip 20 pixels, and we're gonna draw another one. So therefore, it's not right next to each other, but there's some space next to each other.
Okay.
So for each 20, we're gonna draw another pixel. Another pixel, another pellet. So therefore, that's what. And then we go back into the void draw. And then here in the void draw, you're going to write draw pack dots right here, like this. And then, is it on your screen? Do you see it on your screen?
Yeah.
So now, for you guys, your challenge is because we don't have the same rectangles like types, so therefore you're going to have to put it in each row. So you guys are going to have to find out what value can I make it so it goes straight across this here, and how can I make it straight across here using the same formula, the same code that you had here, but just changing some things up. And then you guys can do the same for the columns when you're done with the rows. This is the same thing for the columns, but we're going to be changing the y, or we're using a y variable. Do you need help, Scott?
Not yet.
But if you have, okay, you guys have the grid?
Yeah.
So next, we're going to draw the pack in. what happened was, I'm using the arc function, however, I don't know what's wrong with it. It's not showing me like the mouth part, but that's what it's supposed to be, is the arc. Let me show you. So the arc function basically is supposed to do it, like make it into arcs, leave a little piece of it out, like a pie or whatever. But it's not showing that whenever I use it. But this is the code. I'm just going to show you guys the code I did to make it. So here, before the void draw function, we're going to make another function that's called draw pack. So basically, we're drawing Pac-Man. And this fill thing right here is, this fill line right here is how, is the color, there's a yellow color that we get.
I also have just a big yellow dot.
Okay. So yeah, I didn't know what to do. I'm using the arc function, but it wasn't showing me anything. But, so this was basically the intro to drawing Pac-Man. I have a, I don't know if you guys want me to email this to you. This was another one. I modified, because this is an open source website on opening processing. It's an open source website. So I looked at somebody else's code and other people's code. So I merged them together. And then I created this one where I use the, I'm not really eating the pellets, but I use the, the keys, the up and down keys, the right and left keys, and you could move around it. It's not perfect, but I don't know if you guys want this code. I can give it to you guys. You guys can work it on your own and try to find it, and you guys maybe even like try to get it to eat the pellets. And there's other Pac-Man code open source on this website if you guys want to use it.
Great, thank you.
Your emails are on there?
Yeah.
But that was basically the intro to the open processing workshop that I wanted to show you guys. And there's a lot of other things you can do on it too. It's very cool, very visual.
I mean, the whole website, like just processing.org, has a bunch of different codes.
Thank you guys for coming.
Thanks for being here.